Well, hello there.
Yes, you're in Green Dean's house for a change. We're not outside. I'm not sitting in front of a bunch of ferns. If you go to my website, eattheweeds.com, there it also says Eat the Weeds and Other Things Too. Well, today we're going to talk about some other things too. Many times while foraging, you'll come across a bounty of fruit. It might be blackberries, it might be mulberries, it can be apples, citrus, loquats, cherries, anything like that. And the question is, what do you do with it? Well, our ancestors had one answer, and that was to make it into a wine, or make it into a cider, or to make it into a beer, or something like that. Well, you know, wine can take a couple of years, beers can take a few months, but you can make a very nice cider or fermented fruit juice in just 1 week. Great flavor, about 3% alcohol, and very, very easy to make with no fuss and no bustle. And the reason why I wanted to do that was, when I was a kid, we would go to an orchard and buy bruised apples for our horses, and my mother would always say, and get a couple of gallons of cider. Well, we did that, but my father would also say, but we also want a gallon from that barrel over there. And that barrel over there had hard cider, and it was young. They made it with no great fuss, and it was delicious. And so when I worked on my recipe to get it down right, I wanted to have one that had a good authentic taste, and that's what I've got. So we're going to make an authentic hard cider recipe. I have an authentic, we're going to make it here today. Or actually, it's been over the course of a week. But just remember, it can be used with any gallon of juice as long as it's sweet and has no preservatives. So let's go make some libation. Welcome to Green Dean's Kitchen. Today, I'm going to show you how to make hard cider. It only takes 1 week. Now, the ingredients are fairly simple. You need apple juice, you need some yeast, and you need something fermented in. So here I have a gallon of apple juice. This apple juice, it doesn't make any difference if it's pasteurized. It doesn't make any difference if it has ascorbic acid in it. The important part is it has no preservatives. That's the key. You want apple juice or cider, no matter what they call it, even with particulates, but with no preservatives. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to pour it into this larger container. Now, the reason why I'm going to use a larger container is I could use this, but there's no air space. And I need a little bit of air space for the gas to escape. So we're going to see if we can pour this into here, and it should work fairly well. Now you can use a wide variety of apple juices. I have everything from $12 a gallon organic apple juice in a store from the health food store to frozen orange juice. As long as the frozen apple juice, you could use as long as the juice doesn't have preservatives, you can make cider out of it easily. Now you can do the same thing with orange juice if you're so inclined. You just have to make sure it doesn't have any preservatives in it. So, that's the important part. Now, you need a gallon of juice. It makes a little difference what gallon it is. But here, since we're making apple cider, this is a gallon of apple juice. As you can see, we're getting close to the top. But I need some air space here. So I want to make sure, because it's going to bubble a bit, and I want to make sure, so I'm not going to put it all in. I'm going to reserve about a half a cup. There we go. Okay. Get that out of the way. Now, this is my starter. And if you go to eattheweeds.com, you'll learn more about how I made my starter. Because, you know, the website says it's Eat the Weeds and Other Things Too. Well, this is the Other Things Too. I got this, I went to a health food store, bought some organic apple juice, bought an organic apple, peeled the apple, put the apple peeling in the juice, waited for about 3 weeks, and I ended up with a nice batch of yeast. And I've been using that yeast ever since. So I need about half a cup. So I'll simply shake my little head out here, and I'll put in about a half a cup. Now there's a lot of sugar in here, so it's going to be really heavy. I can see it going down. And we're going to visit this during the week. Now this is on a Sunday. Now, we need a fermentation log. Now you can either use a store-bought fermentation log. Oh, by the way, you can use store-bought yeast. I find the wild yeast to give a better flavor. So, you can use a store-bought fermentation log, which at least goes in here, fill it with water, takes care of that. Now, if you don't have one of those, don't worry. You can take a piece of plastic, plain old saran wrap type of plastic, put it on the top, secure it with an elastic, then take a pin, like a little needle, and put one little hole in the top. That'll serve as your fermentation log as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to let this set. As a matter of fact, because I'm using my own starter,
It should start working vigorously within a day. So this is Sunday. By Monday, this will be working very, very hard. By Saturday, it'll have worked 5 days. I will then bottle it. I'm going to show you what it looks like in between. I'm going to bottle it on next Saturday. Then I let it set out for a day to charge, and then I throw it in the fridge. So that's what we're going to do. We're on our way. Join me in a few days, and we'll take another look at it.
It's been a day, a full 24 hours, since I inoculated my cider with my yeast starter. And while you probably can't see individual bubbles up here in the top, you can probably see movement. That movement is, of course, the yeast eating the sugar, releasing carbon dioxide. And they will do that until the sugar is absolutely gone. So what we want to do is interrupt that process. I will let it work for 5 to 7 days, depending upon the sweetness that I want. That produces a very low alcoholic beverage, only 2 or 3%. And then I will bottle it and let it charge for a day, and then I'll refrigerate it. By doing that, I get it to be carbonated, like a beer would be carbonated, but the cold temperature and the pressure forces the yeast to stop working, and so it doesn't convert the rest of the sugar to alcohol. And that way you end up getting a sweet carbonated cider.
Well, we're back in my kitchen, and this is Saturday, so my cider has been working for 6 days now. It's ready to be bottled. And I wanted to mention that you could do this with orange juice if you wanted to, because the alcohol percentage is rather low. It's 2 or 3%. But I want to show how easy it is to bottle it. I've already poured it off into some little containers here. And I have some 8-ounce, actually the 16-ounce seltzer bottle. They come packed with seltzer water. And I fill them right up to the very, very top. I leave about a half inch space. Then, you see it's bubbling a little, put a cap back on, I tighten it, make sure it's good and tight. Now, I will let this sit up for a day, because I'm in Florida, it's fairly warm, and within a day it will charge, become effervescent like beer. In a northern climate, you may have to let it sit up for 2 or 3 days, but at some point, the bottle becomes hard again. When you first buy these bottles, they're charged and they're very, very hard. But you see, I can just bend that easily right now. I wait until it charges up and I have a hard time bending it. In other words, the bottle becomes charged with gas again. That's when it goes in the fridge. And of course, the combination of the pressure and the cold temperature in the refrigerator stops fermentation almost completely, so you don't have to worry about that. And that also helps age it. So what we'll do is we'll let this set for a day. We'll come back and give it a try. A week ago, we started making this hard cider, and we'll try it in just a moment. I just want to remind you that where I live, making your own cider, wine, and beer for personal consumption is legal, so check your local laws. Also, I want to remind you again that this particular recipe can be used with any particular sweet fruit juice, as long as it has no preservatives or no nitrates in it, things of that nature. And of course, if you want to know more, go to eattheweeds.com and click on archives right on the bottom, and you'll find the particular thing we're looking for. So, this opens up so we hear what it sounds like here. Oh, that's nice. Let's give it a try here. Get myself a little frosted glass. Let's see here. Oh, you know, I'm in charge of quality control around here. I just may have to have two of these to make sure it's good. So until next time, I'm Green Dean. I want you to think green. I want you to eat green. And I want you to sip clean, because there's no preservatives or nitrates in here. Toodles.